Welcome to another video, guys, and today I want to discuss a bit about Yama Ace or Yamato and Ace unit. The new EX that we saw that was announced yesterday or something like that. It depends when I post this video, but yeah, I want to talk about his traits and skills and everything, because I have a feeling that it won't be that good or be strong in the near future, let's say. So first, let's take a look at Ace skills. I will just talk a bit about this because I'm pretty sure that everyone knows them. So as you can see, skill 1, 39 seconds cooldown, and also invincible. And skill 2, ignores enemies defense and 42 seconds cooldown. Now Yamato's the same, 39 seconds cooldown, skill 1, invincible, skill 2, 37 seconds cooldown, and ignores enemies defense as well. Now what I really want to talk about is basically these traits, alright? So I will just take each one of them in particular and talk about it. So for Ace, as we can see, it nullifies a flame, which is good, and when attacking an enemy inflicted with a flame, increase damage dealt by 30%. So this is a pretty good trait, I would say. 30% damage increase is pretty much, and right now there are a lot of units that nullify a flame, and I'm aware of that, but I see and I'm pretty sure that Bandai in the very close future will like to go to the status infliction meta again, because as you can see, all the recent units that are released, guys, doesn't nullify status effects. So based on this, I would say that this is a good trait, because these units will be able to inflict a flame on the future units. So this is a very future proof, let's say, trait, and it works in the present as well, because if you have enough damage, you can just get gear 5th or the other unit below that HP cap to inflict them with a flame, and also reduce the cooldown time of skill 1 by 5%. Very good. Now, when attacked by an enemy inflict with a flame, reduce damage received by 30%. The same thing, it's pretty good to have. Now on Yamato, this is where the things gets complicated, guys, because let's see, first nullify freeze, and also frostbite. This is very good. It will be good against units like Brook and blue attacker Yamato. But when attacking character type Animal Kingdom Pirates, increase damage dealt by 30%, also reduce the cooldown time of skill 1 by 5%, and when getting attacked by the same type of characters, reduce damage received by 30%. So what I'm thinking is that in the pretty close future, like let's say 1 year, I mean it's not that close, but usually EXs, when you try to summon for an EX and get him, you are thinking that, bro, this unit will be good or playable or pretty decent in the meta for a pretty long time, alright? But the thing is that Animal Kingdom Pirates won't be so present from now on. I mean, yeah, sure, I'm pretty sure that in this anniversary, the main EX will be Kaido, and he will be in the meta for sure. There are other units like Albert and the Green Runner Kaido that will be present, but they'll be pretty rare. So I don't really think that this is a future-proof trait, because, as I said, in the future, I don't think there will be many Animal Kingdom Pirates units to deal with, and this is not very good, I would say. Now let's take a look at all the traits that this unit have. So after holding down the skill button, the units will change, resist stagger, being down and knock back for a set period of time after reduces incoming damage by 50% after skill 2 is used. This is pretty good. You won't really nullify status effects, but that's decent, I would say. There are not many units that can inflict you with status effects. I mean, I know there are a lot of gear 5ths in this meta, but if you can time this right without the enemy having Kaminari, you can use this very well. Now, this is where the things are interesting, guys. So, when your HP is 90% or more, damage dealt by normal attacks ignore defense and reduces damage received by 20%. This is a very, very good trade, guys, but 90% is a very high cap, guys. Just for you to be able to imagine, if you have 25k HP, which is a pretty high number, I would say it's obtainable by most players in this game, this means that you will, if you take a single hit of 2.5k damage, you won't be having this trade anymore. So that basically means if you take one or maximum two normal hits, that's it. So this is very good, but I'm afraid that this trade might be a bit too harsh. The cap on this HP is a pretty high cap, I would say. And yeah, I heard that you can change the units. Okay, you can change the units and then you can also get hit while changing, okay? And the second unit will already be under 90%. Or okay, if you time this right, you can use this, okay? But not for too long, that's what I'm saying. And a lot of you say that it has heal on every skill, but we'll go there in a second. But let's continue. When attacking an enemy with a skill, increase attack by 10%, up to 75%. Plus recover HP equal to 50% of damage dealt up to 5k. So, this is a very good trade, guys, because you can use your skills and get 10% attack. And basically, if you stack your attack, you'll be able to get 5k HP on every skill, guys. And that's what I'm counting here. So, I won't be talking about something less than 5k, because I'm pretty sure that all the skills that you use with this unit will deal more than 10k damage for you to be able to heal 5k HP. But even so, guys, this is not enough, I think, because for this to be able to heal you enough to have your HP more than 90%, you will need to be able to spam these skills, okay? And you don't have any high cooldown reduction traits. Let's read all the traits and I'll get back to it, to this topic. When attacked by an enemy whose parameters are boosted, reduce damage received by 30% and resist stagger effect. So basically this is all the meta, I mean most of the meta, but this is okay. This is a very good trait. When attacking an enemy with boosted defense, reduce the cooldown time of skill 2 by 5%. When hit with knockback by enemy, recover 30% of HP. These two traits are very good because a lot of units are have traits that boost their defense. And you can have a lot of skill 2 cooldown, but it's not big. This is what I'm talking about. And the last trait is about units with status effects applied to the enemy, like Shanks, Akain, or Red Attacker Sabo. So these are all the traits, guys. And I don't see any high cooldown reduction trait, guys. Like, I mean, when you, I don't know, KO an enemy or use a skill, reduce the cooldown time of the other skill by 20% or something like that, you know? Yeah, it's good that you have this trait that when you attack a boosted defense enemy, reduce the cooldown time of skill 2 by 5%, but that's it. That's what I'm saying, and this is why I'm afraid that this unit won't be so, like, EX worthy, let's say, because there are other red attackers that can be used and have high damage. Like, I feel like the only good thing about this unit is the damage. And if you are talking about this, we can choose Albar or other red attackers. Yeah, and another thing that I want to talk about is this trait here. When hit with knockback by enemy, recover 30% of HP. So this is very good because most of the attacks in this meta have knockback, guys. So you'll be able to recover 30% of HP. But here's the thing. If you are hit with a Bajrangan or a Stamp or, I don't know, skills that have high damage, it's very, very possible and very, very likely to get hit with more than 30% of your HP. Meaning that even if you get healed like this, you won't have 90% or more HP to use this trait up here. And this is another thing that that's on my mind, let's say. So yeah, I'm a bit worried, let's say, because actually I am pretty tempted to summon, because I'm pretty sure that the Yamato and Ace unit will be pretty cheap. I think it will be like 2.2k at max, but let's see, I could be wrong about this, because it's still a dual unit, but yeah, I'm not sure because of this, and I would like to see other YouTubers using it and get a better opinion about this. So keep this in mind, guys, and let me know your opinion about this unit, because I'm really curious what you think. This was my opinion on it, and take it with a grain of salt, or I don't know, but I'm really curious about what you think. So that being said, guys, don't forget to join the Discord. Please like, share and subscribe, because it helped me very much, and see you in the next video.